Hey, what's up, gardening friends? Jeff here. How's everybody doing? Hope you're doing well. I'm great. Sitting outside with my heptacodiums. Absolutely loving them. Thought we should talk about them. Plant that I've wanted for an extremely long time. I've never been able to get a hold of them. I was at the nursery the other day and they had two left and I had to snatch them up. Let's talk about them. Talk about why they're so great. Why I love them so much. I know these don't look so hot right now. I know. But trust me, they're beautiful plants, especially once they get in the ground and get growing. So these are Heptacodium miconioides, which is the seven sunflower. They get that name because of the flowers that they have on them. This one still has flowers on it, which is surprising. That's where the name comes from. These specifically are the Temple of Bloom Heptacodium miconioides. So these are from Proven Winners. These are a little bit different from the regular Heptacodium miconioides in that these get, I believe, what is it, like 10 feet tall, maybe 6 feet wide, whereas the regular seven sunflower you get 15 to 20 feet high and I think 18 to 10 feet wide. They have a beautiful vase shape to them. They also, the Temple of Bloom Proven Winners version variety, leaves behind more of a reddish calyx than the regular ones. We'll go over all those fun things. I just want to talk about why I like Heptacodiums. I'm sorry that these aren't more pretty. I'll try and have lots of images up here on the screen to look at. First off, these have an amazing vase shape to them that I think is an excellent dupe for a crepe myrtle. If you live someplace like I do, where the crepe myrtles are sort of unpredictable when it comes to their growth, well, really their winter survivability is being able to hold on to their wood through the winter time. They have that vase shape, beautiful brown peeling bark, so that looks nice in the winter time, and also similar to the crepe myrtle in that way. These will flower around August into September. I think maybe the Temple of Bloom, this one might bloom a little bit earlier, I'm not positive, but that's so nice that they'll have a fun show of those white flowers, big clusters of them on the ends of their branches, at a time of year when the majority of the other trees and shrubs that are hardy into zone 5 and 6, those are mostly done. I guess there's like the hibiscus sericurus, Rose of Sharon, those are still flowering, but you get what I mean. As far as a large, small tree, large shrub, you get all that fun color. And then they leave behind those calyxes, those pretty reddish pink bracts, those will last on into the fall. And much as I love the flowers on these, I think they're beautiful. The pollinators go nuts for these. You want pollinators in your backyard? Plant a seven sunflower. Neighbors, butterflies, and bees will thank you for it. Those flowers are beautiful, but that pink and the red show that they leave behind that lasts a pretty long time, I think that it looks pretty freaking awesome. Maybe even more awesome than the flowers themselves. But it's a win-win. So it'll flower for a while, but then it leaves behind that fun clusters of colors of the pink all along the ends of the branches for months afterwards. They bloom on new wood, so that's a plant you'll want to prune in the late winter, early spring, maybe fall. I would hold off till late winter or early spring. They have nice fall interest. The leaves get good color on them. These are just now starting to color up and get some color onto them. Like I said, they're winter interest. They have that pretty brown bark on them. In the spring, the leaves come out with a really heavy veining on them and they look interesting. And then as the leaves push out through the season and mature, they start to get this fun curl and curve to them. Looks pretty interesting. Different from what we see on a lot of other trees and shrubs. I really like how they come down and have just a little, like a gentle curl to the ends of them, a very small twist at the ends. Part to full sun, average water needs, heat tolerant, not really any special fertilizer needs. Maybe use some like the Espoma rose tone. That's good for woody perennials and shrubs. Probably appreciate that in the springtime, maybe again midsummer. Then they can be pruned and trimmed however really you want to, not too much. But you can shape them in various ways. Overall, it's just a fun plant. I'm really excited about these. I got one for the front yard. I have a spot where this will look very nice closer to the house where you can't really put other trees and shrubs because you don't want to block the view of the house and you don't want big invasive roots right near the house either, near the foundation. At 10 feet tall, I can keep this pruned a little bit shorter if I want to. And I enjoy having that vase-shaped structure in front of the home because it doesn't block as much. You can underplant more easily. You have a nice structure with it. And then the other one I got to put in place of my Natchez crepe myrtle, which will have to wait until spring. I will probably drop it in the ground somewhere for the wintertime just to help protect it. If I don't have a cold frame or anything out here, I think it would do better in the ground. And then first thing in the spring, get the plant moved. Oh, that's so pretty. Okay, I pulled up Proven Winners website, see what they actually had to say about the Temple of Bloom specifically, so I can give you what you need to know here. It says that the seven sunflower differs from other heptacodiums on the market in that the bracts, which are actually the sepals, develop a much deeper red color, plus it blooms earlier so that even in colder areas of its hardiness range, you'll still get a chance to see the color develop. Huh. It's also a bit smaller in overall height. There's something I hadn't thought of. All the years that I've been reading about these, I've been seeing them at my botanical gardens. They have some gorgeous just seven sunflowers there. I hadn't really taken into consideration that if it doesn't bloom for you until late August and you live in maybe a really cold zone 5 or even just a zone 6 where you have a shorter growing season, potentially you may not get to actually see those pretty bracts or the sepals that come down. I do know that the seven sunflowers, the Heptacodium miconioides, they are threatened in the native range. At least they were last time I was reading about them and researching them. And until recently, these were really hard to find. I haven't been able to find them for sale in the U.S. ever. The plant I've been looking for maybe a decade, however long ago it was that I first saw them at my botanical gardens, I've wanted one of these. So I'm super excited to have gotten these. A little shorter than what I would prefer for the backyard at 10 feet tall, but beggars can't be choosers. I will take it, especially knowing that it's going to bloom earlier. I like that because that means that we'll get to see the pretty reddish pink dangly bits on the branches longer in the season. I should say I have been able to find the Heptacodiums for sale, but it's usually just like a stick and I haven't had the patience. So when I look back, had I had the patience, I would already have them by now. You get my point. These are nice larger plants. They do look sad, but that's okay. They'll look great next year or well, maybe a couple years from now as they get some growth on them. These are a type of plant where they just look to me like they will always do better in the ground. Container life, that may just not be for them. Well, as is the case with a lot of woody shrubs, right? So there it is. I know, not the most beautiful to look at. Hopefully I had some fun things up on the screen so you get a better representation of what these will actually look like once they're out and planted into the garden. So excited to have that fun shape, the various different gifts that it gives throughout the different seasons with the colors and textures and whatnot. Those blooms, the pollinators, I love planting for the pollinators. Cannot wait to see this covered in bees and butterflies next year. I don't know if it'll be covered because they're not that big. In a few years. Who's got seven sunflowers in their yard? Who's been growing these shrubs, these trees, Heptacodiums? Comment down below. Tips, tricks, suggestions. Always appreciate it. It's how we all learn and how we grow together. Anything you have to add to the conversation with these plants is more than welcome. Love talking to everybody. Just say hi. And that's going to do it. Short video. Just a quick spotlight of a new plant that I have that I'm really excited about. Everybody's doing well, having a great day and a great life, and everything's just going beautifully for you. And of course, as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. I'm having trouble finding different things to zoom in on because they're so sad looking. These need to get into the ground. Just picked these up from the nursery yesterday, so I'm gonna go ahead and get them planted up here. All right, keep on growing, everybody. Bye bye.